On the heels of his battle with Congressman John Lewis on this MLK Day, Donald Trump met behind closed doors with Martin Luther King III, the son of the civil rights icon.
Isn't there something that just cuts to your core when you hear the president-elect refer to John Lewis as all talk and no action? I mean, nothing could be further from the truth, isn't that right?
No, absolutely, I would say John Lewis has demonstrated that he's action. As I said, things get said on both sides in the heat of emotion. And at some point, this nation, we've got to move forward.
But it was only a brief reprieve from the controversy swirling around his inauguration. The incoming 45th president is slamming German Chancellor Angela Merkel for allowing Syrian refugees into her country.
I had great respect for her. Yeah. I felt she was a great, great leader. I think she made one very catastrophic mistake, and that was taking all of these illegals, taking all of the people from wherever they come from, and nobody really knows where they come from. You'll find out.
That drew this sharp response from Secretary of State John Kerry to CNN's Christiane Amanpour.
I thought, frankly, it was inappropriate for a president-elect of the United States to be stepping into the politics of other countries in a quite direct manner. He'll have to speak to that as of Friday. He's responsible for that relationship.
Trump appears to be placing Merkel in the same category as Russian President Vladimir Putin.
Well, I start off trusting both, but let's see how long that lasts. It may not last long at all.
Trump is once again signaling a new, softer policy on Russia, hinting in a published interview that he wants to work out some sort of deal with Putin. Russia is hurting very badly right now because of sanctions, but I think something can happen that a lot of people are going to benefit. And Trump sounds like he's not sold on the NATO alliance.
And I said a long time ago that NATO had problems. Number one, it was obsolete because it was, designed many, many years ago. Number two, the countries weren't paying what they're supposed to pay.
President-elect is still fuming over the disclosure that U.S. intelligence officials briefed him on unsubstantiated allegations that Russian operatives claim to have compromising information on him. Trump is slapping back at outgoing CIA Director John Brennan, who said the incoming president should treat Russia with caution. Trump tweeted, "Oh, really? Couldn't do much worse. Just look at Syria, red line, Crimea, Ukraine, and the buildup of Russian nukes. Not good. Was this the leaker of fake news?"
It was John Brennan, someone who the president-elect is supposed to be trusting, that came out and attacked him on his breadth and depth of understanding of Russia, which is unbelievable.
Trump is again raising questions about how he will repeal and replace Obamacare, telling the Washington Post his plan is insurance for everybody. But the transition is offering few details.
The president-elect made it very clear to the leadership in the Congress that he wants to do repeal and replace simultaneously, and we're working earnestly to do that.